Hello friends, this is Sarita Binman from UPSC Aspirates, Indian Heritage and Culture, Indian Art, Dance, Music, Puppetry. In India, various facts of performing arts are all pervading the bringing color and joy to numerous festivals and ceremonies and reaffirming the faith of the people in their heritage. These facts have been responsible for sustaining the long continuance of ancient tradition. Indian music music is as old as our cultivation. The presence of the music dance in Indus Valley civilization is evident from some musical instruments such as the arched or bow-shaped harp and few varieties of drums on the terracotta figures and pictograph on the seals. About the music in Vedic era. In Vedic era, the priest composed hymns in the praise of the nature god, which had to be sung or chanted at religious sacrifice. This tradition led to be the composition of the sizable body of the religious poetry, which we call Shruti literature. Origin of the sarangi. This essential note in Indian music was three, which Udat, Anudat and the Swaritra. The Samved employed more notes and the dust finally settled down on the seven notes, which were Krusht, Pratham, Dvitiya, Tritiya, Chaturth, Mantra and the Atiswar. This later evolved into what we call the seven swaras. Origin of the Indian music. As per the Indian mythology, Indian music is divine origin. Narad was the first sage to whom the laws of the music were revealed. Veena is the oldest music instrument which was invented by Narad. Dumbru was the first singer. Saraswati was the goddess of the music. Maurya era and music. The way of the Raksha and the Rakshis have been dipped in the Buddhist sculpture. It is obvious that the Maurya era had to be richly flourished music. However, Buddhist theology saw music is distraction, but nevertheless, music flourished in that of very era well. Very well. Development in Indian music. In later phase, the Gupta period is known for the excellence in the field of the Indian art and culture. The reference to the music in Gupta period work comes from the works of the Kalidas and the Vatsavayan. Among others, Kalidas was to retain the name of the some instruments such as the Parivadani and Veena, Vipachi Veena, Pushkar, Mritang, Vamsi, Shankha. In the post-Gupta period, a great treatise, the only after the Natyashastra, composed in the Sanskrit as the Prihadeshi by the Mandanga Muni. Prihadeshi is the first text to be speak about the rage and the distinguish the music genres into the Marg Sangeet, classical music and the Desi Sangeet, folk music. Influence of the Islam on Indian music. Around the 9th century, the Sufi tradition had itself a firm foothold in the India. The Sufi mystics are known as the folk great love for music and the acceptance of the many indigenous customs. Impact of Bhakti movement and Indian music. The impact of the Bhakti movement on Indian music was through the Astachap and Haveli Sangeet along with the Bhajan and the Kirtans. Using the regional language, Braj Avadhi or the whatever as the vehicle, saint composer were able to reach to people in social struggle that otherwise impervious to the influence of the art and music. Mughal era and the music. During the Mughal period and especially under the Akbar region, temple and music were largely overshadowed by the Darbar Sangeet. In which music was composed mainly due to the Ilugos. Ilugais, the patrons, the court of the Akbar employed many musical instruments and the music Indians as well as the Persians. Times of the Akbar are known as for the complete fusion of the Persian and the Indian music systems. Jahangir was the generally interesting in music and the generally patronized the arts of was the with Shahjahan. However, Puritan Aurangzeb banned the court music. Still, some literary work on music were produced in the time, such as the Persian translation of the Mukhutar. In the 19th century, the thumri form of the nomadic and devotional music also became the popular in the 19th century. Ramnidhi Gupta or the Nitu Babu gave us the Bengali tap and a new genre is assimilated in the feature of the tap Hindustani music and the lilting rhythm of the Bengali music. In the 20th century, in the early 20th century, the most important contribution to Hindustani classical music was that of the Pandit Vishnu Digambar Paluskar and the Pandit Vishnu Narayan Bhaktakandi. Thank you, and please subscribe my channel.